Hello and welcome to Trade Compass. I'm Jesus Serrano, here at the World Trade Organization headquarters in Geneva. Today, we turn the spotlight on this international body, which is celebrating its 20th anniversary in January 2015. The year holds promise for progress on international trade. With us is today the WTO's Director General, Roberto Azevedo, who shared his hopes on the advancement of the Bali Commitment on Trade Facilitation and the Doha Development Agenda.
One important thing we did is we created a trade facilitation agreement facility, which now has raised a very high level of interest on the part of donors, for example. We already have people engaged. The beneficiaries are very much mobilized, trying to see how we're going to implement that, because the facility is not only going to be about funds to finance the technical assistance to be provided, it is also about finding partners and helping developing country members to reach the donors, to reach the technical assistance providers, to reach other international organizations that can help. And therefore, we are not only talking about funds, we are talking about partnership with a large number of countries, donors, entities. International organizations are going to be a big part of that. So the World Bank, we have been working very closely with the World Bank, but also others, UNCTAD, the ITC, of course, WCO, World Customs Organization, and many other partners that we are working together now. We have to continue the implementation of the Bali decisions, and that is extremely important. And there are many steps that we have to follow. And then we have to also, of course, move on to the work program. And the work program for the conclusion of the DDA is the biggest chunk, I think, of what we have before us. And the most important thing is to retain the sense of urgency. This is something that is needed, systemically important. We have to do it quickly. More than that, I think we also need to have a high level of engagement, including in capital. So that's something that the countries have to be mindful of. And also, a sense of pragmatism, where people show flexibility in the things that we can achieve, and a high degree of sensitivity to what is possible and what is not possible. So it's about focusing not on all items of our wish list, you know, from A to Z, but which ones are really important and that I really need for this round. By July, we should be finalizing the work program for the conclusion of the DDA. That's a very important mark. By the end of the year, we have attributed priority also to conclude the negotiations on public stock holdings for food security reasons. So that's very important. We have the ministerial conference also in December in Nairobi, the 10th ministerial conference. We have in the middle of the year, we have the global review of the Aid for Trade initiative, which is also extremely important, and we'll have heads of international organizations, we're going to have donor countries here, we have the beneficiaries also together at the highest level. So this is going to be a very important event as well. We have the public forum in October, which is also another important landmark in the agenda of the WTO. It will be not only discussing trade and discussing the challenges of the world, the global economy, but also celebrating what we have done and achieved over 20 years. We need to help in whichever way we can to deliver growth, to deliver jobs, and trade is clearly going to be a very important part of that. Our hope is that the membership will be mindful of the importance of the WTO as a contributor to growth and jobs, but also as a contributor to global governance. The WTO, together with the World Bank and the IMF, integrates the tripod of global economic governance. So I hope that people will remember that we have a very big role to play in all economic and trade issues, and that they show the political will that is necessary to deliver the kind of contribution that the WTO can give in this scenario.
Trade is a tool for development which can help to improve lives and livelihoods around the world. Countries can trade their way out of poverty into prosperity. The WTO believes that traction in trade can help to propel the global economy towards greater growth in 2015. I'm Jesus Serrano. Join me again in the next edition of Trade Compass. Thank you for watching.